Hey everyone, well thank you so much for joining us tonight for this really special communion experience. On the night we recorded seven, we had a really powerful time in worship as we worshipped with the song Communion together, and then Pastor Louie Giglio came and ministered so powerfully, leading us into the receiving of communion together. And after that we just sat in that moment, we sat in that reflection on the cross, on Christ, on his sacrifice. So I'm going to read now from 1 Corinthians chapter 11. While I'm reading, if you're not ready already, why don't you go and gather the elements, just some juice and bread if you don't have a little communion cup, but why don't you just prepare the elements and also prepare just your hearts as we enter to receive in the coming moments. 1 Corinthians chapter 11 from verse 23 says this, "For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." I love that as we take communion together in the coming moments, that we are part of proclaiming Christ's death and resurrection until he comes. It's a powerful thing that we do as the body of Christ. And this is going to live on here online for a while, so you can revisit this as many times as you want. There's a lyric in the song we're about to sing, take it as often as you will. So as often as you need to, why don't you come back here, revisit with us, take the bread, take the cup, and enter into that contemplation of what Jesus has done for all of us. Okay, I'm going to pray and then we are going to enter in together. Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for every single person who has tuned in and is watching this right now. I thank you, Lord God, that though we are not in the physical space together, we can join together in spirit as we contemplate the cross. We can join together, Lord Jesus, as we approach you on the level ground of Calvary. And I invite you, Lord Jesus, just to minister to us afresh as we contemplate and remember and meditate on you and the great sacrifice that you made because of your great love for us. So have your way in these coming moments. We thank you. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
This is communion, your body broken, the cup we're drinking is bittersweet, the gift of friendship, truest salvation, born of your suffering on Calvary. Stained to spot.
So there is a symbiotic relationship between the grace of God, or salvation, and worship. And symbiotic is just a big word that means you can't have one without the other. It's like breathing. You can't breathe out unless you breathed in. And you can't breathe in unless you breathed out. And it's that way with grace, or with salvation, and with worship. Where there is no grace to be breathed in, there is no worship to be breathed out. And there is worship to be breathed out because there was grace to be breathed in. And so we come to communion. Not a thing on the run sheet, not a sacrament of the church, but a moment to be with God. To commune with the Almighty God of the universe. Can you think of it tonight? Can you imagine it tonight? I hope we haven't been in church too long. I hope we haven't come to worship too many times. That we're still not blown away tonight that the King of Kings came down. And not only did he come down, he sat down at a table he prepared for you. Our shepherd prepares a table before us in the presence of our enemies. In the midst of the storm, in the midst of the battle, in the midst of a broken world, in the midst of whatever's coming against you, the Lord Almighty says, I prepare a table before you. And I come down to that table and I sit down at that table. And it's not what's at the table that's going to get you through. It's who's at the table that's going to bring you through. I want to commune with you. And the promise tonight is not that God's going to change all of our circumstances in this moment, but the promise is that he's going to sit down at a table with us. And so we want to just create some space for a moment. And we want to just breathe freedom over this room. That everyone in this room would know the King of Kings wants to commune with you. He is here in our midst. He is in this place, but he wants you. He came for you. Yes, he shed his blood for all of those who God had called, but he comes for you tonight. And I don't know where you're coming from, but I know where he's coming from. He's coming from the throne of thrones by way of Bethlehem's manger, by way of a cross where he paid for all of our sin, by way of a tomb where he defeated death and hell and sin in the grave. He comes to us now by the power of the Holy Spirit from the throne of thrones where he is seated on high. And he's coming for you tonight. And he's coming for me. So you have the little communion cup. And why don't we just negotiate that little thing for a moment so we don't have to do that later. There's two things, as you know. One is on the very, very top. And under that is the wafer. And so let's just take that out and put that in one hand. And then we'll know where that is. And then all we'll need to do is pull the other top and the juice will be there. And before we do that and move into that moment, I don't want to overlead this moment. I want to let you have the freedom to be where you need to be with the King who comes to commune with you. Seven words. I said, Lord, could you just give us seven words for communion? This whole thing is about seven. Then can you give us seven words? And he says, yes. Hebrews 8, verse 24. Moses had a covenant, but a new covenant is coming. It is a new and a better way. It is a final and a finished way. Where with the old covenant, it had to be done year after year after year, but this new way is a final and a finished way. And he said, and I want you to know this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to write my word in people's hearts. I'm going to write my words on their minds. And then he said these words, your sin I will remember no more. Your sin I will remember no more. Do you believe it? So Jesus, on that day when his followers were gathered together, he was revealing himself. He was unfolding his plans. And so like he had done many, many times, he took the bread and he broke it. But on this night of nights, this beautiful night of the new agreement with God, he said, this, friends, is my body broken for you. It's a whole new agreement. A whole new deal. It's not you, it's him. It's not us again, it's him forever. He said, take and eat it, for whoever eats of this bread will live and never, ever die. So let's take the bread as we remember him. And then Jesus lifted the cup, knowing that seven words would be spoken over your life. Heaven speaking to you. Your sin, I will remember no more. Our God doesn't have a memory problem, but we do. And he said, as often as you do this, remember me. As often as you take this cup, remember me, because you have amnesia spiritually and you've got to often come to the cross again. You've got to often embrace the cross again. You've got to often embrace what I've done for you again. Often lift the cup. often lift the cup. And as you do, remember me. Don't forget that I've spoken over you. Your sin I will remember no more. And he said, this is my blood. It is the blood of a new covenant poured out for the forgiveness of sins. So as you take this cup tonight and share in the sufferings and the finished work of Jesus, receive that you are loved, cleansed, forgiven, made new. You are righteous and clean. You are in Christ forever. You are healed and whole. Do this, he said, in remembrance of me. Thank you.
Amen. Psalm 23 verse 5 says, "You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you for the last few moments together. We thank you for your supreme sacrifice. We thank you for your blood shed and your body broken. And we thank you for the table, Lord. We thank you that by your sacrifice, because of your sacrifice, there is a place for us at the table where we can return in the presence of our enemies and feast on your presence. We thank you, Jesus. Have your way in our lives. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us, and thank you to Pastor Louie Giglio for that incredible time of ministry. We are super grateful, and thank you, Jesus.